I think you could almost say that the sort of photographs Derek took are the equivalent of what has become the selfie. If I'm out and about on the town now, I take my own picture for the record. I've characterised me being a show-off, I've got my friends in the background, I want to tell the world who I am or where I am. In a way, I suppose, that's what photographers like Derek were doing 40 years ago.
So I used to just stand around in these clubs on my own very often and watch them mostly, and then ask them if I could take their photograph when I saw that the opportunity was the right one. I used to hang around so long so that they just forgot I was there very often.
I mean, I think it was very important that Derek has taken all these photos because it captures a time when there was so much energy, free energy. It was very, as they say, organic. People came out with outfits, put on so many different clubs. It was such a cross-culture of things that was happening at the time, and it is so nice that Derek has caught this on camera.
If anything, back in Derek's day, when you're having a photograph taken, it was like more of an event, a celebration, you know? It's still special now, it's just, you see it more often, you see it a lot more often.
If Derek's pictures give you a flavour of what a rather exciting and furtive and no-holds-barred nightlife was like 30 years ago, it might whet young people's appetites today to realise what they might be missing. If, for example, you can't keep your life secret and your cult secret thanks to social media, I think if young people look at Derek's pictures, they might just get a thrill out of thinking, I can keep some things to myself. I can go off and have a good time with my friends and create my own little scene.